Hello students, welcome back for another class. So our today's topic is instrumentation amplifier. So let me remind you, this is one of the very important question from VTU point of view, okay, from your exam point of view, very important. So this topic has two diagrams for you to draw. First one, this block diagram you have to draw. So if you see this diagram, block diagram, you can see there it has three different stages: input stage, intermediate stage and output stage, right? Input stage is provided with physical quantity to be measured. What is physical quantity? Give me some examples of physical quantity. One of the very famous physical quantity is temperature, right? The temperature of room, the temperature surrounding you, right? It is a physical quantity, right? Such quantity, when it is to be measured, it requires to be converted into electrical quantity, right? Like you have thermometer, right? Digital thermometer. Temperature is measured and displayed on your screen, right? For it to be displayed on screen, it is to be converted into digital form before physical quantity into electrical quantity, we require to use a device called as transducer. Okay, so this transducer will be coming into your input stage. The job of transducer is it will take the this will take the information of the quantity which is to be measured and converts it into the electrical form so that further it can be processed. Alright, so input stage will be having transducer and preamplifier. The preamplifier means before doing amplification, the preparation work will be done here. Okay, so transducer and preamplifier will be coming into input stage. Next is your intermediate stage. In intermediate stage, you will be having instrumentation amplifier. The job of instrumentation amplifier is to amplify the signal coming from transducer, Then finally you have output stage. Output stage, you will be having an indicator or automatic process controller, wherein in place for the purpose of indicator, you may use a, if it is analog system, you may have an oscilloscope which will display in analog form. You may have a digital recorders, magnetic or sorry, digital recorders or digital and all these stages will be interconnected with transmission lines, okay, interconnecting lines. So same explanation is written here about transducer, instrumentation amplifier, okay, what are input devices, what are output devices, okay. What for an instrumentation amplifier is used is written here, one last sentence: to amplify the low level output signal of the transducer so that it can drive the indicator output or any display is the main function of instrumentation transformer. Now listen carefully. Suppose we are measuring temperature here. Our transducer will convert this physical quantity into electrical quantity, but that particular electrical quantity will be of very small signal. The amplitude may be very small. Though it is temperature, but it may be small, very small. So that signal cannot drive your LED to display that the temperature is 26 degree, 16 degree like this, because that signal itself is very small. For this signal, if we can amplify this, then we give it to LED displays, then it is possible for us to see this on screen. So for this, that low level signal of transducer, which is the output of transducer, is to be amplified, then given to the output devices, where it can be displayed on digital screens as well as on analog screens. Okay, this is why we require instrumentation amplifier as an intermediate stage between input and output stage. So how exactly the circuit diagram is here? Will be fitting as one of the arm of your bridge. You have learned bridges in your electrical measurement subject, third sem, right? Different bridges you are in, Kelvin's bridge, Wheatstone bridge, right? You remember something about bridges like balance condition, unbalanced condition, right? When the bridge is balanced, no current flows in the galvanometer, it shows null reading, right? Voltage will be becoming same at both the junctions. So in this bridge, you see here, when the bridge is balanced, VB is equal to VA. VB is equal to VA, right? So A1, A2, A3 are the three op amps connected here. Okay. And finally, you have indicating meter here. Indicating meter, which will indicate. This here, it is shown as analog form. It can also be in digital form. The figure shows differential instrumentation amplifier using transducer bridge. Yes, as the resistive transducer whose resistance as function of some physical energy is connected in one arm of the bridge as shown above, where RT is the resistance of transducer and delta R is the change in resistance. Very important thing here. Now see here, all of you concentrate on this bridge part. RA, RB, RC are the three resistances, right? RT is also resistance. When temperature varies, the resistance of an element also varies. Okay, here we require to use a variable resistance. Variable resistance in the sense, whenever so with the variation in resistance, RT is going to vary with plus or minus delta R. RT is going to add up or it gets subtracted, like plus or minus delta R. If it is plus delta R, then RT will increase. If it is minus delta R, RT will decrease. Okay. So I mean to say is, whenever temperature varies, the resistance of transducer RT varies. With this, bridge which was in balanced state earlier will come into unbalanced state when the temperature varies. Okay, so all this is about how this happens here. Okay, we'll see further. Under balanced condition of bridge, VB is equal to VA. What is this VB and VA? Where it is? See here, VA equal to VB when the bridge is balanced, right? If it is so, then if you connect a line between VA and VB, in between, across VA and VB, if you connect a galvanometer, it should read 0 amperes, null reading, when it is balanced. This we call it as bridges balance. Okay. VB can also be written as RB VDC divided by RB plus RC. See here, if I apply voltage divider rule, VB is supplied by a voltage VDC. Right, the opposite voltage is VDC, and between VB and VDC, which resistance is coming? RB, right? So if I apply voltage divider rule, VB equal to RB into VDC whole divided by RB plus RC, the sum of resistance, RB plus RC, okay? RB plus go through my notes. Okay, now if the bridge is balanced, I can say that if VB is equal to VA, then I can write the ratio of the resistance of arms, RC by RB equal to RT by RA. Very important point. This I can write only if the bridge is balanced, remember. So generally RA, RB, RC are selected equal in value to RT. Okay, as the physical quantity to be measured changes, the resistance of transducer changes and causes bridge to become unbalanced. Very important thing. Earlier it will remain balanced, But due to change in variation in the temperature, the bridge becomes unbalanced. So we cannot write VA equal to VB. Now it has become VA equal to VA not equal to VB. So this has happened because there is a change in resistance, right? The change is delta R. Let the change in resistance RT be delta R. So we can write the above equation VA and VB once again like this. Here we have written, right, VA, VB and VA. Same thing can be rewritten here. Suppose VA equal to RA VDC, RA plus RT it was, right? Along with RT plus delta R is added. Whereas VB is as it is still. No change in VB. VB has not changed. Only VA has changed. Right? Now, I want VAB. Okay, so VAB is obtained as VA minus VB. If you simplify this, and however, if RA, RB, RC, RT equal to R, then we have VAB equal to delta R VDC whole divided by 2 into 2R plus delta R. Okay. Now, the gain of the differential amplifier is given as minus RF by R1. Another thing here, I missed out. Here, VAB, what we have taken as VA minus VB, which is more here, VA or VB? I'll come to this, VA. Earlier, RA, RB, RC, everything is same. Applied voltage is also same. So, VA and VB will be same, right? But due to change in the resistance, RT has become RT plus delta R. So, the denominator of VA, RA plus RT plus delta R has increased. The denominator is increased. So, what happens to VA? VA will decrease, right? So, VA will decrease compared to VB, right? So, we can write VA less than VB. We can write VA less than VB, isn't it? So, we have to subtract VB minus VA, right? So, you don't require to do that. Just keep that minus polarity with VAB. VAB is equal to minus. That minus comes here. Okay, VAB equal to minus delta R VDC whole divided by 2 into 2 delta R, 2R plus delta R. Remember, this minus is because VA is less than V2. V2 is greater. Okay. So, the gain of the basic differential amplifier is given as minus RF by R1. Okay. I want you to mark minus here. In my notes, it's not written. It's showing as plus. I want you to make this as minus here for VAP. Okay. Come down. Finally, V0 is equal to input multiplied by gain, right? Input multiplied by gain. What is input? VAB is the input is coming through your VAB, right? So VAB equal to V0 is equal to input is VAB multiplied by gain minus R by R1 is the gain. So what is VAB substitute? Minus of minus becomes plus, so you will obtain all positive values here. So as delta R is very very small, therefore 2R plus delta R can be approximated as only 2R. Only 2R. Okay, only 2R you have to write. If you write 2R, it becomes 2 into 2, 4R. Right? In this equation, 2R plus delta R is only taken as 2R. Delta R is neglected because it is very very small compared with compared to the 2R, okay? Then you will finally obtain RF by R1 equal to delta R by 4R VDC. This is your final equation. The output equation of V0 indicates that V0 is directly proportional to the change in resistance delta R of the transducer. This part is very, very important, okay? Final equation and final sentence is very important. So this tells you that whenever a variation happens in the temperature, it is correspondingly, it will reflect on the output. It will correspondingly reflect on the output of your system. So system job is to keep on reading the temperature, and it keeps on happening because proportionally the output is being varied. Okay. So this will end your module 1 as per syllabus. Okay. Now I'm having some of the question papers of 15 and 17 scheme. 18 scheme I'm not having. So point out which are the important questions, and I will have another class on that before starting module 2. Okay, thank you.